Our first step will be to make sure view is cropped, shadows are on, and we also want to set up the sun settings for this view. I also recommend putting a scale bar on the view. After setting up the view, we can open the shadow color tool from the Add-ins toolbar and start our shadow study. We are going to click Add Element, go back to the Revit view and pick an element, which could be any Revit massing or linked CAD. The first element that we'll pick will be the top layer. The shadows of this layer will be on top. Now I'm going to add more massing. The layers in this study are the city context, approved, and our proposed development. We're going to assign color for each layer. By clicking on the preview image, we can immediately see our view with the assigned colors and test the impact of our new development. With the shadow intensity slider, we can change the shadow intensity. Under Shadow on Mass, we can change the color source of the shadow cast on the mass. We can make the shadow to be invisible, gray as in Revit, or keep the color. We can create an outline for our shadows by clicking on the outline checkbox. We can also add a site and assign a different color for the shadow within the site. So I'm going to click on Add Site and select the property line from the Revit view and assign a color. I'm going to keep it gray. As you can see, the shadows within the site are now gray. To hide the shadows, I can choose white. By checking the line width, we can change the line width. Before we export an image, we can select the image quality. After everything is set up, we can go to File, Export, and we can export the image or place it on a sheet. Thanks for watching.